Good evening, everybody. I welcome each of you who have joined this webinar from different time zones. My name is Febin, 1992 civil pass out and 94 structural engineering, both from BSc Tech, and I'm currently the secretary of the Chennai chapter of the Alumni Association. Thanks for joining us for today's webinar. The Chennai chapter is really happy and proud to host this webinar with a very interesting person about whom I will be talking soon. Our chapter has members from 1959 batch to the latest batch, which are active and participate in the alumni activities. Credit goes to all past and present presidents and committee members of the chapter who shoulder the responsibility efficiently and give relevant programs for the alumni. The chapter works alongside the parent chapter for connecting with the alumni. We had been conducting regular monthly talk shows, cultural events, family get-togethers, beach walks for the alumni. However, the last 4 months we are, conducting online webinars like this. And Chennai chapter is in the process of enhancing our digital operations, and we are creating a global online platform for all PSGNs to connect. We have launched an online membership registration that will enable formation of a database for alumni to connect with each other. We have a strong 25-member team of executive committee comprising members from 1962 batch to 2018 batch whose tireless efforts keep our chapter alive and interesting. Thanks to our President Ratna Kumar for this initiative and support from his team and to all the ACE members. Currently, we're also pursuing formation of a Tech Chamber of Commerce about which we will be announcing soon. So we had conducted, this is the fourth webinar that we are conducting. And we try to ensure that we bring to you accomplished and eminent alumni to speak to all of us. Today's guest speaker is Mr. Annamalai. I'm sure all of you know him. So welcome, Mr. Annamalai.
Thank you, madam.
He's the chief mentor at the We the Leaders Foundation. He's an ex-civil servant, a farmer, author, sports enthusiast, founder of Core Talent and Leadership Development. He is a multiple personalities into one person. Mr. Annamalai was born in Karur district and belongs to a family of agriculture background. And he pursued his undergraduate Bachelor of Engineering Mechanical in PhD College of Technology. In 2007, he completed, after which he completed his Master of Business Administration with a specialization in marketing and strategy at IIM Lucknow. An individual with a desire to contribute to the society, he entered civil service and served in various locations for the period of almost 10 years. He resigned from the civil service in 2019 because he decided to take up public service for motivating the youngsters, primarily focusing on empowerment and the development of youth, and has been outspoken about the same throughout his tenure and beyond. He's now the founder of We the Leaders Foundation and also the founder and co-architect of Core Talent and Leadership Development Private Limited. He's very much interested in entrepreneurship and his favorite hobby is reading. He's well known for his work and has also been called as Karnataka Singham, as you all know, because of his integrity and manful attitude on specific disputes. He was a 2011 batch of IPS officer. He started his police career as the assistant superintendent of police. And then he was later promoted in 2015 as superintendent of police. He served there till 2016. After which he was promoted as Deputy Commissioner of Police in 2018. He began his public service with the motto to foster youngsters for the better development of India, believing that rural India has abundant potential for sustainable development. He has received many awards. He received the Vice President of India Award for topping the Director's Assessment for the training period. And he's a winner of Esprit de Corps Award at Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration. He received the Sanghe Laden Shenga Award for showing exemplary leadership qualities by 1992 batch of IAS officers. And he got the Young Achievers Award at Youth Alumni Congress at our own college. Welcome again, Mr. Annamalai.
Thank you, madam.
So we have Jayanti Kannan, who is the host of the evening, and she's going to interview Ms. Annamalai. She's one of the very active members of the Chennai chapter, and she spearheads many interesting programs of our chapter. We're very enthusiastic towards all activities and supports the alumni activities. Welcome, Jayanti. So she is a 1993 alumnus of PhD Sandwich Batch, and she is the joint secretary of the Chennai chapter currently. She is a trainer at Madras Management Association, the past JCRET chairperson of Madras Metro Junior Chamber. She had a 10 years stint at corporate at Crompton Greaves, after which she founded SSS Placement Consultants Private Limited, where she's been doing 12 years of recruitment consulting to companies in India and abroad. She's a corporate and in-house trainer, and she engages specialists also for the training as per the client requirement. A passionate trainer herself, she has handled more than 20 batches of in-house training program on campus too. Corporate. So we're going to have a very interesting session today. During the registration, we have collected a lot of questions from all of you. So what we have done is we have actually gone through all the questions. We have grouped those questions, and that will be taken up today. I request all of you to keep your mics on mute so that the program goes seamlessly. Please also keep the system volumes high, and also use headphones for a better audio experience. If time permits, we'll also have a live Q&A session, but we'll try to answer all the questions. So have an exciting session. Over to Jayanti.
Thank you, Fabin. Once again, very good evening, friends. On behalf of Chennai chapter and all of you present online, I welcome once again Mr. Annamalai for this event. Basically, this event is designed for first 15 to 20 minutes of Mr. Annamalai's speech, followed by the question answer session. As you are aware that we have already grouped the questions, and we will definitely try to do the justice, and I will put across as many questions as possible to Mr. Annamalai. We have close to 800 registrations from our alumni members across the globe, and we have even our super seniors, you know, passed out in the year 60s and 70s, logged in and waiting, not just for a change, but to listen to the man who is change personified, Mr. Annamalai. There's a famous Albert Einstein's quote which says, "The measure of intelligence is the ability to change." By that measure, Mr. Annamalai Kuppuswamy is an exceptionally intelligent man, one who has fearlessly embraced change. He has charted an extraordinary journey from humble origins to positions of power, and is still willing to risk all of it in order to catalyze social change. Aram seya virumbu aathichoodiyin mudal variyai moolaganamaga kondavar Thiru Annamalai avargal. So with this, I hand over the floor, sorry, the air to Mr. Annamalai. Over to you, Mr. Annamalai.
Madam, thank you so much for the kind and the gracious introduction. Ellarukkum vanakkanga, to all the super seniors, to all the seniors and batchmates and juniors. It's a real privilege to be a part of this forum. We always keep hearing about the Chennai Alumni Association, the work they do, and the benchmark they have set for other associations. It's a privilege to come here and talk. Like most of you, I've done something in life, something different in life. Today, it's an opportunity that is given to me to talk before you for the next 15-20 minutes about a little bit about myself, and more about the vision I have, and more about the path that we all should take in the next 10-15 years for the state of Tamil Nadu and India. So I belong to the 2007 batch Sandwich Mechanical. I come from a town, a village called Thottambatti in Karur. So I entered PhD Tech in 2002. The day one, I still remember, me and my father, we changed to two buses. We went with an iron box, and we stood outside the gate. And I still remember telling my father that Tappa vandrum nanikiranga pa thirumba poyarnonu. I told him maybe we came to the wrong place. I somehow felt I don't belong, a small guy from a small town. The whole campus itself was very intimidating. I still remember the day one of PFG, going in and people taking good care of you. And I see that most of the people have come from tier 2 and tier 3 parts of Tamil Nadu and parts of Kerala. So very soon we felt that we belong to PhD Tech. So I'm sure most of you would connect with me. Most of you would feel the similar way. So what started there has taken me in a different path. So today I will talk about it. So the most significant event for me in PFGS, PFG Tech taught me what not to do in life. So for many of you, it is about what to do in life. For me, engineering is about what not to do. Maybe third, fourth year of my engineering, which is a 5-year course, I felt I'm not going to sit for placements, not necessarily a corporate placement, because somehow I still didn't have the clarity about what to do. Maybe now people say that I got clarity at 17, at 18, and 19. And unfortunately, I never had clarity 3 years into my engineering, 4 years into my engineering. Somehow I felt what I'm studying in the campus is not connected to the problems I've seen in my village. It's not connected to many of the problems I've seen outside. I still remember very boldly, I called my father in the 5th year beginning, before the placement season was about to start. I told him, Appana, placement ukarla. Then he told me, what are you planning to do? I said, I don't know, but I need a break and I need to think about it. So I still sat for placement because my sandwich placement coordinator, Balasubramaniam, who's a dear friend, wanted me to sit to get that 100% for the patch. I got an offer from the TCS, Tata Consultancy Services. I got the offer letter there and I gave it to Balu that day. Same evening, I said, thank you, Balu, for the kind words you had for me to force me to sit for a placement, but somehow I don't belong. So the next 1 year was very tough for me. 2007 to 8 was very tough. It enforced toughness for me. I traveled so much during that time, met a lot of interesting people, spoke about life, spoke about society. And I got a small job with a company called Time in Coimbatore, where they gave me an opportunity to teach mathematics. And with the 8,000 rupee salary, my first salary, I remember 2007 to 8, I stayed outside where the rent was 4,000. And by about 20th, 21st of every month, when my money is about to get over, I used to skip a lunch. 22, 23, 24th of every month, my lunch gets skipped. So 27, 28, when the money is about to run out, I used to skip a dinner because my father didn't talk to me. He told me not to come home because I went against everything and I chose not to sit for a placement. But I believe 2007 to 8 is the best year of my life, the greatest year of my life. It showed me a lot of things about myself. What am I good at? What should I do? With that clarity, I wrote CAT. I felt I have to do a master's in higher education, an incomplete education, I felt, with a technical education. I went to Lucknow with a very open mind. I remember the first day in UP, I took a flight, possibly the first flight of my life, landed there in the airport. When I came out, I saw a lot of bull waiting outside the terminal. With no Hindi, I negotiated a 200 rupee ride for an 800 rupee ride. I paid 800 bucks, went to the campus, not knowing any language. So 2008-10 in a foreign land was also a great experience for me. Again, a foreign land, the language is an issue, struggling. Everybody is a batch topper. People have come there, I've seen, are the top guys in the class, but I'm an average guy, 70%, 80% guy. So that grinding, it happened to me, the projects, it made me to travel around UP. I went all across UP doing projects for Melinda Gates Foundation, a lot of other places. That is the time I felt, somehow my life is into social change. I should dedicate the rest of my life, all my energy into making an impact at the grassroots level. With this, I went and met Mr. Vijayakant. Vijayakant was an actor who started the DMDK party then. So I went and met him in Chennai in 2009 for my MBA internship. I told him, I'm an MBA guy, and somehow I like you. I think you are a change for the state. And I would like to join you as an intern. An intern from IIM doing a political internship is unheard at that point of time. My dean straight away told me that I can't do it because IIM Act doesn't allow it, Societies Act. I went and met Mr. Arjun Singh, went all the way. Arjun Singh was the HRD minister then. So Vijayakant kindly gave me a space to work with him for about 3.5 months in the South Tamil Nadu, the rural dusty part. I was grinding it out for the 2009 Lok Sabha election. Again, a great experience. So I think 2007 to 10, where I pushed myself into a different direction. Probably I didn't have clarity, but still I was willing to risk it out, take a new path and go around. So the previous speaker, Mr. Mafai Pandirajan, was a candidate in Virudhunagar. Then I worked for him. I was an intern for him. I was part of his political campaign. I still remember he was an MP candidate from DMDK, Vijayakant's party, standing in Virudhunagar. He was doing a lot of innovative things. I was part of it a bit for some time. So from there, when I was about to complete my education, politics definitely I felt is not my cup of tea, but the experience I had then was fantastic. So social change, what better than civil service? Wrote civil service from the campus, got selected into the police service, though I wanted IAS as the first option. IPS was the second option. For my rank, I got IPS. With an unwillingness, I entered into the police service. I think the first 2 weeks when you start wearing that uniform, you go to that parade ground, when you stand in that crowd, when you get measured, people shout at you, the utsas for the drill and running around, that gave me a fascination for the uniform, fascination for khaki. So then 10 years went like a zoom, 9.5 years went like a zoom. SP of 3 different districts, I've served 6.5 years, then DCP for 2 years. So a very fantastic experience. Every single day I liked what I was doing. I was able to do a lot of great things, but there was this nagging feeling always that somehow grassroots change I was not doing it. What I saw with the 2009 elections in Tamil Nadu, what I saw in UP, I'm not able to get and change it. As a police guy, I was more changing the manifestation of a social problem. Any social problem gets manifested in a certain way, it becomes a police issue. And I was able to do that, but somehow the passion was always to go back deep down and do some change. So I didn't know, I know it was a very risky one to quit police. Again, the same thing, whether I can go back to grassroots or maybe I can still stay with police for the next 25 years and start doing something which is very meaningful, but not according to the passion I had when I entered the service. So I undertook a pilgrimage to Kailash Mansarovar, 2018. I went for a 69-day pilgrimage, no cell phones, nothing. In the high altitude, 18,000 feet plus for about 40-50 days with an enforced silence. That gave me a lot of clarity. It gave me a lot of courage and a lot of vigor. Came back, told my wife, I'm doing this. Called up my dad. My dad by then has given up on me. He's like, every single time you keep doing this, it's like day in and day out, it's the same problem with you. But this time, luckily, I had his blessing. He said somehow he trusted that my heart is in the right place and probably I'm going in the same trajectory. So quit in September 2019, again took a break. I always take a break whenever I quit to see whether I'm doing it out of compulsion, out of passion, out of real direction, or maybe I'm just doing it for the heck of it. So 6-7 months, again, the same travel, Uttarakhand and other parts, high up in the Himalayas. So with a very clear direction and purpose, came back to Tamil Nadu. Started a foundation called We the Leaders, based out of Karur, getting into Coimbatore, some operations in Kadalur as well. So we work in predominantly in rural parts. We work with college students, we work with farmers. In Karur, we work with about 5,500 college students. We train them, thanks to one of our alumni, 247.ai, the founder, Mr. Shanmugam Nagarajan. So with the CSR project, he's with us. It's a massive project we have taken, 6 colleges, 5,500 students. We train them on communication, behavioral, and critical thinking. So they're part of the foundation now. And we also have organized a group of farmers, about 1,550 people now. So we have launched a farmers producing organization. So absolute grassroots, we help them to do their soil testing. We help them to find out their market for their produce. We help them to find out the weather patterns. And deep down, we are working now. We have about 6,000 volunteers in one district, Karur alone, with about 1,700 in Coimbatore and about 600 in Kadalur. So till now going is good, but again, the focus is always on bringing change at the grassroots level. Because one change we bring in one house, it sets a chain reaction, it sets a cascading effect. It goes all the way to Delhi, it goes all the way to the Rashtrapati Bhavan, it goes all the way to the Prime Minister's office. So that is the mission and the focus. Till now it is good. We keep doing it and with a clear sense of purpose and direction for the next few years also. And why is it I've done what I'm doing now? Maybe a police job itself is fantastic, no doubt about that. But the reinforcements I had, seeing what is happening, it will change everybody. Any cop who's more grounded, who's more empathetic and who's always having his ears and eyes to the ground, will always be a different guy. Policing will change you for the better because you see thousands of deaths. You see deaths and deaths and deaths. So death is always our constant companion. The day starts with somebody dying and some police guy reporting. And the day ends with somebody dying and somebody reporting in the middle. Many, many times where I had the unfortunate task of calling up a loved one and telling them their son is dead, their father is dead, wife is dead, kid is dead. So two things happen. Some people become very hardened. They don't get any kind of sense on them. And some people become more emotional. They become more, maybe more grounded. So I am the second sort of guy. So every death is a constant reminder to always live our life with a lot of purpose, to contribute something back, not to take more from the earth, to live a simple life, but a very meaningful life. So death is always a constant companion. That is always a privilege wearing khaki and serve to the best of my ability in Karnataka. So many people, for them, it's a shock because for a typical civil service guy, it is never to quit. No civil service guy quits. Any civil service guy who's quitting will always say, I hate the system. System is bad or somebody is bad. So they fight and quit. So my thing always was that we should always know when to say no. There is always a time when we know that it is right. It is up. So go to the next one, start from the ground up and keep working. For me, it was that moment, maybe the Kailash Mansarovar moment. Without any regrets, I said, though I've disappointed a lot of my friends and batchmates and people who to this day still believe I made the wrong decision, probably I should have stayed back. And my resignation letter also I mentioned, probably it's a great service. It was one of the greatest service in the world. Being a cop is closer to being a god. No two ways about it. If one is grounded and empathetic, the kind of things we do, the kind of things we get an opportunity to make an impact at the ground level is fantastic. But somehow, I think with enough experience, enough motivation, I think we should always get into the next one. To again start from the grassroots, use all our wealth of experience, take it back, help those people, the youth, the farmers, whoever needs us, and change the society. A longer perspective I always have without any doubt is to take a plunge into politics, no doubt about that. It's the best instrument of social change. Like Plato, who says, the highest virtue of any human being should always be to get into politics. He said it many, many years back. It's a great virtue, but only thing is the political landscape in our country right now, it's rotten, it's so bad. It's not very conducive for I don't know. I'm not saying good people. You are good. I am good. Everybody is good here. But for a well-meaning guy, for a guy who wants to come in, or for a lady, the current landscape is not very conducive. It's very tough. Though I have conducted many, many elections, I've seen elections in and out, the politicians in and out. But it's always tough in a country like us because we are still an immature democracy. Still, we are maturing. The caste is still a big problem. The economic disparity is still a big problem. People still don't vote for the right guy. People always vote for whom do they think is right, who takes care of them, who gives them money. Nothing wrong with the voters. Voter is always right. The Indian voter is always right. So that is the spirit I have. But we wanted to prove at the ground level before jumping into politics, before asking for anybody's vote, because asking anybody's vote is a privilege for a human being. So we thought we'll go to the grassroots level, create that moment, create that change. Build enough leaders, because if you look at the We the Leaders Foundation's motto, as Madam said, is Aram Seya Virumba. That is a motto with which it was founded. And the other motto we have is Nammil Oru Thalaivan. So we always say a leader should always create more leaders. Insecure leaders keep creating followers. But here there is no post for anybody. So this organization is run very differently. We always go by the volunteers number. My number is 7. There are 6 people before me because they registered before me in the website. So my number is 007. So that's the way we run. And every single project is led by a team, led by a resource whom we think is best for that. A group of 10 to 15 guys, the initial beginners, we sit down, we decide the new path it has to go. Then we delink ourselves. Moment a new team takes over, it is purely their baby. So we have completely disrupted the foundation model in India. We don't have designation. We don't go by the founder's credo because there is no founder. There is only volunteer or a beginner. I call myself a chief servant, Mudanmai Tholilali, just to take the same spirit deep down. So since I got only 15 minutes to kind of rewind my whole life, it is not that I did some great things. Absolutely no. I'm sure all the alumni here are extremely distinguished, fantastic alumni, people have really made impact in their industries. I had always the unique honor and privilege of meeting you across India, different circumstances. So for great people you are, but the only thing is we all travel in different paths. You travel in a different path. I travel in a different path. At the end of the day, we all converge. That's the reason I said it's a privilege to talk to you all. And probably my path is different. That is why the organizers felt it's fit to call me as a guest and talk to you. with all humility, I'm here talking about my life and the vision I have for our country. If we don't get into grassroots, don't create change, don't make impact, don't bring up our farmers, I don't see anything great happening in this country. An edifice cannot be built on loose foundation. An edifice cannot be created with insecure people. An edifice cannot be created with leaders who are not passionate. And a great cathedral cannot be built with leaders who keep looking over their backwards. We need leaders who are enlightened. We need leaders who are more forward-looking, more visionary, who has got something to give to the state, something to give to this country. So this state is such a great state. It started somewhere, gone in a different trajectory, different direction. Now, if you look at the current state of specifically Tamil Nadu, because most of us are Tamilians, we belong here. There's nothing great about where we are traveling now. So I'm not sure whether I'm jumping and talking. So moment my time is up, Jayanti madam can tell me so that we can get into questions. So this is a state which has got about 4 lakh crore as debt now. Tamil Nadu has got about 4 lakh crore. The reason I'm telling you this is very intelligent people like you will quickly grasp what is happening. So it's very tough to have this conversation with the outside world. So 4 lakh crore is a debt. And every year, Tamil Nadu borrows about 70,000 crore. We keep borrowing, and then we keep giving subsidies. And this state is one of the states which makes a lot of revenue from TASMAC by selling liquor. 31,000 crore is the last year, which grows about 6% every year. Now, these are the basic statistics for you. Such a great state with a huge debt burden, with a great emphasis on TASMAC, with a great emphasis on the freebie culture, with a great emphasis on the 500 rupee note and the 1,000 rupee note and the 2,000 rupee note before every election. So how long can it sustain itself? Probably we inherited a great one. So are we leaving the same state back to our kids, to our grandkids? That's a question before all of us. So that is also one of the motivation for many of our volunteers. Maybe I come from a certain motivation because I had with God's grace, I had a bit more exposure. But the volunteers, the 6,000 people who are with us now in Karur and 1,700 in Coimbatore and 600 in Cuddalore. So those guys, I really salute them because people come from different parts of the world. People come from different cities of Tamil Nadu. People come from very, very, very high pedigreed backgrounds. When I keep talking to them, what is your motivation to join us? Every single person tells me it is to do something right with the state, to do something right with the society. And seeing their belief, it inspires us. Seeing their belief, it gives a lot of motivation to us that possibly we are on the right path and there is a big stone in front of us. It's like the atlas, it keeps pushing up the stone up and the stone keeps coming down. But somebody has to push that stone because the stone never goes up. It's an endless chain reaction or an endless motion. But we have to do that. So that is a motivation. So every single day when a new volunteer comes, I find their number, I call them up, I talk to them, I ask them, what is your motivation? How do you think we can make you to be a better person? How do you think we can help you to contribute back to the society? So I request the eminent alumni here to also look at our organization, vetheleader.org, vetheleader.org, to look at it. And see whether you can contribute in any way. You would like to take a project in your place so that we can facilitate, we can act as a catalyst, we can help you out. So that is a mission and progress we have. So there are n number of people who keep doing a lot of great work at the societal level. Again, I'm not using a word called great. There's nothing like great. Everybody is doing great work, including a guy who's working in a company because he pays his tax very honestly. So he's also doing a great work. There is somebody who's struggling in the hot sun, a farmer who gives us food. He's also doing a great work, but qualified great meaning somebody who's contributing back to society. I'd only hope and pray that Tamil Nadu is able to pull in all of those people, unite them, make them part of its fabric, part of its culture, because it's a toxic environment. Any single thing you do, there is a big political interference. Although I've served in a different state, I've seen other states also, but it's very tough here. Very, very tough. It's a deep grassrooted system. And without struggle and without passion, it's very tough to create a change. Wherever you go, there is always a political interference. There is always a politician who thinks we are entering into his turf. And he comes with his people. And that's a big thing. So that is the reason I'm asking you to contribute back. So that way you can really make sure this state progresses to a different level. The reason you see a simple reason, a simple data, In the corona time, the state itself has said that everybody who is working for the government of Tamil Nadu, they have extended their tenure by 1 year. If you ask me, why did they do it? Why should government servants work for one more year extra? Because the state doesn't have money. The state simply doesn't have money to pay them. The state simply doesn't have money right now to pay to its staff. The state doesn't have money right now to pay a full salary to pay to its corona warriors. Maybe the front end nurses, the front end the policemen, the front end the other important people in our society. Because it is run with a very different notion. It is run extremely with a different notion. 3 lakh crore is our budget. 2019 and 2020, if you look at the budget of the state, it is 3 lakh crore. How much did the state mobilize by itself is only 1,69,000 crore. That's it. 1,69,000 crore we mobilized inside. But we spent 3 lakh. The central government gave about 70,000 crore because of the taxation devolution. We borrowed another 70,000 crore. And last year, out of the 3 lakh crore, we had spent only 30,000 crore to create schools, roads, hospitals. Would you believe? If we run a household, out of the total budget, if you are spending only 10% to create an asset, and remaining 90% we just spend like that for subsidy, for giving freebie, for giving scooty, for giving that, what kind of citizens are we creating in this state? A state that is famed for its hard work. A state that is famed for its integrity. Maybe if you go to a different part of Tamil world, India, maybe Karnataka, Tamilians are highly respected 10 to 20 years back. They say, very disciplined, very clean, very integrity. Or chinna vela kuduthina kuda pakkava pannuvaanga. But now, more Tamilians are seen as drunkards. Some of the culture has forced them to drink more so that the state earns revenue. So all these things have to change. Somebody has to speak here. The problem is when we switch on the TV channels, it is more about people shouting at each other, what happened to Periyar, what happened to Anna, which nobody is bothered about 40 years back, though they are very important personalities, no doubt about that. The whole argument goes around it, Dravidian politics or the aggressive Hindutva politics or the religious-based politics. So time is now when we have to speak on issues that matters to us, issues that is important to us. So that way, I'm sure that we all can bring back some glory to the state and to this country. So that is my introduction. That is my whatever speech madam has forced me to give. So thank you so much, madam. Any questions you have, I'll answer it. Or if you want me to talk, I can talk. Thank you so much, madam.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Mr. Annamalai. You really kept us all enthralled with your inspiring, energetic and a very insightful speech. In fact, on the life journey itself, you know, very beautifully how each time, you know, when you transition from one phase of your life to another, romba beautifully are they explained panninga with a lot of insights.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Arise, awake and stop not till the goal is reached. All power is within you. You can do anything and everything. This is what comes to my mind because this was the quote by the youth icon Swami Vivekananda. But when I listen to our own PSG's youth icon, Mr. Annamalai, this is what comes to my mind. That was wonderful, Mr. Annamalai.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam.
So can we move on to the question and answer session?
Yes, madam.
So as Fibin ma'am said, we have collected the questions from all the participants and we have grouped them together. So since we are all connected today in a common platform, not Zoom, but PSG. So we will start with your PSG days. So neenga college la galata ellam panirkeengla, any interesting incident you can share with us on your tech days?
Many interesting incidents, ma'am, but I am not a great guy in the classroom. I'm not a front bencher, neither a back bencher, somewhere in the last but one row. So the first 3 years was more like a very simple year. Fourth year, I remember, sometimes we all do stupid things. I had my share of one. We did a small strike for the mess. So doing strike in the mess is a DNA of a PhD techian. So all batches must have done. But for me, the lesson was very important. That day, we did a strike because a sambar powder packet was beyond the expiry date. Somebody did a strike and we all joined without even knowing what is the purpose. But finally, when the top guys were identified, luckily I found my name in there among the top 8. So summoned to the principal, and principal said, all of you have to take your luggage and get out. But the top seven guys were Tirupur guys, all big mill guys, and those guys, they're very happy to leave. I said, sir, if you don't mind, one of these guys goes out, I'll close the door and fall at your feet, sir. So that was a big embarrassment also, because a lot of times we mindlessly do things. For me also, that was a mindless moment. So that was very, very interesting, that fear that they'll kick me out of the campus, I might not get my degree. So that still lingers on always. So before I jump, I always think whether it is right, should I really do it? But maybe God pushed me into a law enforcement job only later. I keep telling this to my police guys also. Whenever I see a college student going on a strike, and my guys have to get aggressive, many, many times I hold back all the sub-inspectors and inspectors. I said, don't do it. There will be guys like me inside. Find those guys. Talk to them. So that is one, ma'am. Second, the whole PhD experience itself is fantastic, ma'am. The whole camaraderie that we shared with different batches in the hostel, that itself is a lot of great instances. So no doubt about that. The clubs that we were part of, specifically the Dramatics Club and a different club, every single place, it gave me an option to grow. I still, one more incident I remember is the tsunami, ma'am. 2004, when the tsunami happened, I was not a part of the NSS team, but I was very, very interested to go to tsunami and contribute something.
So, as NSS?
NSS, ma'am. But my batchmate, Mr. Veeramani, who's in US now, he is the NSS secretary. He was the NSS secretary. I went and begged him. I said, somehow take me into NSS today and take me to Kanyakumari. I will contribute something to tsunami. So the management was very clear, because of the spread of disease, only about 10 people can go. So Veera told me that I'll be a photographer. I said, I don't even know what to photograph, because I don't even know how to handle a camera. He said, no problem. I'll give you a camera. Learn for 2 days and come. Because maybe he was convinced of my passion to go and do something there. So I went there. The whole trip was a very, very horrific experience. Seeing the dead bodies floating around, and the dead bodies thrown about a kilometer into the coconut trees, people cleaning. We were carrying goods and other things on behalf of the PhD tech. So after we came back, when the photographs were developed, when the coordinator was seeing the photo, many photos did not have the head of the participant. Some photo did not have the legs of the participant. Many photo, the subject matter was something else. The goods itself was not covered. So the principal was asking, what is the proof that we have given? Where is the photo? And they didn't know that. They always thought that I'm an eminent photographer. So that is again a funny feeling. Even now we share the photos in the group and keep laughing.
So then you joined photographic club, I think.
Correct, ma'am. But still, even now, I'm a bad photographer only with all. Okay.
That's nice. Neenga vandhi ipdi solringa. But there is one person during your college days, that in your first year, who has identified you as a unique personality. He says, I was your first year roommate. I have observed you and I found there was something unique in you. Very happy for you. This is from Mr. Nambi of your batch, who was your roommate, Tribil. So I think there's someone who has identified you as a unique personality even at that time when you were so young. Oh, that's nice. Then
maybe now, thanks to Nambi, ma'am. Thank you so much.
So now you have done your BE from tech and then moved on to do your MBA from a prestigious institution, again IIM Lucknow. So the usual tendency is to go for an MNC job or go abroad. And you said you didn't like it, but what inspired you at that moment to go for civil services?
Ma'am, I think specifically UP, specifically Lucknow, very specifically the hinterlands of UP, the travel that I was forced to take in my second trimester. We were working on some projects for a foundation. So when I was on the Purvanchal side, Purvanchal is that UP-Bihar border. And the assignment that was given to us on behalf of the Melinda Gates Foundation is more about children dying within 10 days, 20 days after their birth. And they wanted some creative jingles and creative advertisements for that. So when we were trying to find the reason when I found shocked me, it said, people don't breastfeed their child. Many women don't breastfeed their child. When I asked a woman, why don't you breastfeed? She told me, sir, the breast milk is devil. In our culture, we are not supposed to give devil to our child. It truly shocked me. the level of ignorance that people had in that part of India, and the level of belief system that kept going from generation to generation. So nowadays, when you talk about infant mortality and all those things, people like this still exist. Now, though we designed some creative jingles to counter that, all those stuff, that left a small imprint. Likewise, each instance when I kept moving around, it kept showing me that the society is absolutely in a flux. It requires a different kind of approach to solve it. So that is why the third, when the internship happened, came, I said I want to do a social internship. When I was trying to do a social internship, I felt going to the grassroots should be the best option. So luckily I found a political party, went and worked for them as an independent consultant for 3.5 months, ma'am. So for me, UP was very specific, ma'am. Maybe if I've gone to any other campus to study, I'm not sure whether I would have got the same level of impact I had in UP. So you some days you feel like crying. Some days you feel like cursing yourself. Some days you feel like, kicking yourself. I still remember some of our batchmates, because the campus is about 30 kilometers away from Lucknow. We the campus is in a place called Prabhant Nagar, Sitapur Road. So many people, when they come, their laptops get robbed in the same road. Their purses get, people show knife and take all the money. And some of my batchmates got stabbed also. When you go out, it's not a crime that is happening. It is not a crime that is happening. It is more out of desperation, more out of economic things they do. So that was a deep imprint for me, ma'am.
That's nice, sir. So you cracked your IPS in first attempt, I think.
Maybe I was lucky, ma'am. Maybe I was lucky. So it is not that I was able to crack in the first attempt, ma'am. I still remember my scores were pretty poor. My written scores were very poor because I was doing my MBA also, writing my mains also. So I used to come from classroom at about 8:39. Then 3 hours I open and whatever I could read, I read. Next day sleep in the class. That was a routine in the second year. So for me, what happened, ma'am? Somehow I was clear that I might not crack it in the first attempt, but I took more out of experience. But I was able to crack the mains when I was called for the interview. Then a little bit of confidence came in that I should crack it. So interview, I was the All India topper of that batch. I was able to score 240. That is score that is yet to be beaten, even after 10 years, with all humility, ma'am. So that interview pushed me inside. Interviews pushed me inside. So that is why, ma'am. So with all humility, it is not that I was able to crack it in the first attempt. I just got lucky with the board also.
That's nice. And hearty congratulations for breaking the records and holding it high.
You have come out now, ma'am. So thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Still, record is a record.
No,
I still keep saying I got sent him in 12th. So, andamari da. So, like next to ungloda Karnataka, ungloda IPS career. Now we will move on to your life journey, into your IPS career. So, Karnataka la, neenga pannina sadhanaigal ella eppadi vandu oru enna solradhu oru notorious naxalites surrender panna vecha dhairyamagatam. You know, 7 minutes la FIR, or samanya makkal kudukra or manu ku 7 minutes kulla FIR podradhu and 7 days kulla problem solve panna mudiyungra or assurance kudukradhu, indha mari ethaniyo or vishayangal nariya pannirkeenga neenga Karnataka la. There is one question. In your police career, which spans close to a decade, any challenges and difficulties you have faced and how to become independent in government career?
I mean, every day is a challenge, ma'am. In a police career, every day is a challenge. I remember 2-3 times the bullets also missed me. So you get lucky also. The rub of the green is with you. But what happens is, ma'am, a policeman becomes very spiritual. I don't know why. You become very spiritual the first 2-3 years into your career. Because the death affects you more, as I said in the beginning of my speech also. I remember the first death I saw. I was a trainee in Shimoga, just out of academy and into the field. So when the sub-inspector told me a whole family has died, come, we'll go to the spot. When I went to the spot, I saw a husband, wife, and a small kid. They went to that shanty. And the Sandek Poit, ma'am, they were coming in that Hero Honda vehicle, the correct side of the road at a correct speed. Opposite la pathingana, one Scorpio guy comes at full speed. Probably he loses control, maybe a tire burst, I think, ma'am. They lose control, he runs over the divider, comes to the opposite direction, runs over this two wheeler. So all three people die in the spot. When there is a small kid, maybe less than 6 months, was having a bit of life. We were trying to struggle, and the ambulances were also not so great. I'm talking 10 years before 2011. So ella panni she died. That was a big, big impact. Big, big impact. I remember telling my officers there, life la karma enanga, you do good things and God will give you good things. That's the karma. So what did they do? If they had made a mistake, it's fine. They never made a mistake. In the mari ethaniyo instances, ma'am. In the first 6 months only, you get so many instances. Life just throws instances at you every single day. So every time it's a challenge, every time. For me, I would not say that I did this, I did that. For me, every time when somebody dies, I always tell my officer, I should break the news. I didn't tell him, madam. Maybe second year when I was SP Udupi, yaro yarandu poi enoda sub inspector vandu enoda office la irukkaru, he just picks up the phone, he tells the father when the son died, unga paiya irandutan station ku vaanga neenga kaiyiluthu ponnom. It was like a matter of fact. It was like a speak. I was like, what is happening, bloody fellows? Edhukku ipdi pandreenga? Why are you speaking like some event has happened? It is like somebody's loved one has died. Probably their whole life is revolving around their child. How can you say like that? A lot of training also, ma'am. I'll come to the police station. The whole idea of making the police station ISO 9000, we made a lot of police station ISO 9000, is to build the empathy, ma'am. Not so about efficiency. Efficiency can always come back, but empathy was important for me, ma'am, as a police leader there.
Very true. It is not just a news what you pass it on. You know, you correct. Have to feel for correct. Their loss.
So I took it it's on always as SP also. Any child or any person who's below 35 who's dying, you'll tell me, I'll tell their parents. So I must have spoken to about 500 parents, 500 people like that. So every time you tell it, there is that moment of silence the other side. For about 6-7 seconds, they've just processed that. Then they just pour everything on you. So that is the greatest, I don't say experience, ma'am. It humbles you. It shakes you to the core. It helps you to redefine our life. So that is something from the police, ma'am. So reminding everything is fine, ma'am. With your power and everything, you make the Naxalite surrender. You encounter criminals. But everybody
power can come. Power comes with your post, but this empathy doesn't come. You know, correct. It has to come from within. Correct. So அந்த ஒரு இது நீங்க காமிச்சிருக்கீங்க, அதுவும் ஒரு போலீஸ் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்லனா கேக்குறதுக்கே ரொம்ப சந்தோஷமா இருக்கு. ஏன்னா உங்களுக்கு நிறைய பேர் என்ன கேட்டிருக்காங்க அப்படின்னா, in fact many questions are you know similar to this. Why usually police officers are rude and not friendly with public? இந்த மாதிரி நிறைய கேள்வி கேட்டிருக்காங்க. How can we foster collaborations between citizens and the state and rebuild trust? எல்லாருக்கும் என்ன ஒரு ஃபீலிங்னா, போலீஸ்னாலே வந்து இந்த நீங்க சொல்ற மாதிரி there is no empathy. So just ரூடா இருக்காங்க அப்படிங்கிறது. அத பத்தி உங்களோட வியூ என்ன?
மேம் தி again ma'am, just to give more depth to my answer, I remember the government of India sent me to Germany in 2018 to understand the German efficiency and German way of policing and bring it back to Karnataka and to train our guys. So you'll be very surprised, ma'am. The first thing when I went to Germany and visiting all their academies from the Munich to all different parts of the country, one thing I saw, everything revolves around empathy. In the training space, everything revolves around empathy. They respect the citizen. They feel the citizen is the most important part of the country. They believe he is the VVIP one. So training pathingna andha mari kuduthirupanga ma'am. So adala veli varumbode not only it is drilled down, every single fiber, every single cell of his body believes a citizen is an important component of their country. So India la neenga pathinga appadina the training is just about 7 months. Adala poi drill panna laati eduthu thooku left right center panna indha maari nama training liye vandu we make lot of mistakes ma'am. Training is not very depth, though we tried doing this in Karnataka in the Mysore Police Academy for a couple of batches. Even now it is being followed. But training based on empathy and soft skills, speaking and other things, ma'am. So first I would fault the training issue, because the government doesn't pay or give money, spend time in training. The second, ma'am, what happens, na modhalaye sonna mari ma'am, policeman nariya experience paaka paaka he becomes very hardened. So that's a very unfortunate part. Each experience is supposed to make you a better person. So a policeman paathina nariya paathu paathu sagajam eduthu aarambichuvaanga, paravala sir idha sir nadakkum, irandu poitan sir, naam enna panna mudiyum sir, what can we do? இதை பிரேக் பண்றதுக்கு ஜெர்மனில என்ன பண்றாங்கன்னா, எவ்ரி ஃபோர் இயர் அகெயின் தி ரீட்ரைன். ஸோ நீங்க ரீட்ரைன் பண்ணி பாஸ் ஆகலைன்னா தே வில் நாட் சென்ட் யூ டு தி ஃபீல்ட். So the empathy is re-emphasized. India la pathina the average training a constable goes after his first training is only one. Next 30 varshathula ore or training da pannirukanga. So which is very sad. Idu vandu police reforms la fulla pannanum. We have to completely redo the whole structure, completely change it. And for this we need good politicians and good government who thinks policemen reform aaglina society reform aagadunu ungalku or feeling kondu varanum. Unfortunately that is not the case now. நான் ஒரு பழைய ஹோம் மினிஸ்டர் கர்நாடகா ஒருத்தட்ட கேட்டேன், ஏன் சார் நீங்க ட்ரைனிங் கொடுக்க மாட்டீங்க, ஏன் நீங்க ரிசோர்சஸ் கொடுக்க மாட்டீங்க? பிகாஸ் வி ஆர் கெட்டிங் த பேட் நேம். த பேட் நேம் இஸ் நாட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் அ காப், த பேட் நேம் இஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த சிஸ்டம் இன் டு விச் அ காப் இஸ் பார்ன். சோ அன்லெஸ் யூ சேஞ்ச் த சிஸ்டம் தேர் இஸ் நோ வே அ காப் வில் ஆக்ட் பெட்டர். அவர் என்கிட்ட என்ன சொன்னார்னா, இட்ஸ் வெரி இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் மேம், ஹி டோல்ட் மீ, அண்ணாமலை உங்ககிட்ட நாய் இருக்கான்னு கேட்டார். யூ ஹேவ் அ டாக்? ஐ செட் ஊர்ல டாக் இருக்கு சார். ஹி செட் யார் சாப்பாடு போடுவா? ஐ செட் மை மதர் ஃபீட்ஸ். எவ்வளவு சாப்பாடு போடுவீங்க? ஐ செட் மை மதர் பேம்பர்ஸ், நிறைய சாப்பாடு போடுவாங்க. இல்ல இல்ல இல்ல, அப்படி இல்ல, நீங்க கிராமத்துல போய் பாருங்க, ஒரு நாய்க்கு எப்பவுமே பாதி சாப்பாடு தான் போடுவாங்க. எ டாக் இஸ் நாட் நெவர் ஃபெட் ஃபுல், எ டாக் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் ஃபெட் ஹாஃப் ஸ்டமக், பிகாஸ் எ டாக் ஹேஸ் டு பார்க், தட் இஸ் இஸ் எசென்சியல் குவாலிட்டி. ஒரு போலீஸ்மேன் பாத்தீங்கன்னா டாக் மாதிரி. ஸோ ஃபுல் வயிறுக்கு நீங்க ரிசோர்சஸ் கொடுத்துட்டீங்கன்னா இட் டசன்ட் பார்க், இட் ஸ்லீப்ஸ். ஐ டோன்ட் நோ, திஸ் இஸ் தி கைண்ட் ஆஃப், திஸ் இஸ் தி கைண்ட் ஆஃப் லீடர்ஸ் வி ஹேவ். And this is the kind of people who decide how much money should go into policing and all those stuff. That's a problem, ma'am. A state like Karnataka, 660 crore is the total police budget. அதுல 600 கோடி ரூபாய் வந்து உங்களுடைய சாலரிக்கே போயிடும். 60 crore வச்சுக்கிட்டு நீங்க என்ன பண்ணுவீங்க? You can't even build 2 police station. You can't even create anything. So in the environmentல வேலை செய்யற பிறந்த ஒரு மனிதன் வந்து வெளியே வந்து போலீஸ் ஸ்டேஷன்ல ஒரு போலீஸ்மேனா வேலை செய்யும் போது, யூ சி த வேர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஹிம், யூ டோன்ட் சி த பெஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஹிம். The society wants to see the best of everybody. Sorry for the long answer, ma'am, but it's a systemic problem.
Okay. So you said you have created many police stations with ISO certifications. You know, we have heard of ISO certifications only in corporates wherever we have worked. But, you know, you have taken efforts to get that certification, ISO certification for your police stations where you have worked. That's an excellent initiative. But still we have questions on again the police station related questions. Your views on recent Sathankulam police custody death of a son and father?
It's a shameful act. It's a black day for Tamil Nadu police, because Tamil Nadu police pathinga ma'am, it is generally known for its fabulous policing. Without any shame, policemen across India, they believe Tamil Nadu followed by Andhra are the best police forces in India. Karnataka comes third or fourth. That's the general order. You know, Tamil Nadu police is known for its efficiency, rigor, and its law and order maintenance. This police force has produced legends, ma'am. Walter Devaram, Vijay Kumar, ellame. Anala Sathankulam abdingiradha, I'm going to take it as a one-off incident. It is like some rebel who by hook or crook is able to get into the system, and he was able to show consistently exhibit that pattern. So the moment Sathankulam nadandha odane, ma'am, I was more interested to see who are those guys, that sub-inspector and the inspector. When I digged into their record, whatever the available online media is there, I found this guys had a consistent pattern. 3-4 police stations, beating people, getting suspended, getting transferred, and getting pushed to a insignificant station. So adanal Sathankulam vandu idu karuppana oru vishayam, bad ana vishayam sonna kuda, ma'am. Unfortunately, we are not able to weed out those guys. If our system pathinga na ungalkala corporate la vandu performance matrix la the bad guys gets weeded out. So government la pathinga na the bad guys never gets weeded out, because it's a time bound promotion. 7 varshana inspector, 13 varshana DYSP, 20 varshana additional SP, 25 varshana SP. That's a set career path. Evlo per vandu reject agra or batch la pathinga na less than 0.4%. So this is the bad thing, ma'am. So a corporate culture kondu varano, rigorousness in implementation evaluation kondu varano, because there's no point getting emotional and next 2 years nothing will happen, we'll forget Sathankulam, again a new Sathankulam happens, again we become emotional. So to make sure it doesn't repeat again, na first day sonna mari reforms idala kondu varano, ma'am. Very very rigorous selection process and very rigorous promotion process, idu rendu pannuninga na neriya black sheep veli anithirlam, ma'am. That is the only option, there's no other.
So on the change again, we are coming back to change.
Inti, sorry to interrupt both of you. Just to all the participants, we are nearing 7:30, but we are, we are witnessing a very interesting session. So we'll be slightly extending the session. Just wanted to say that. Go ahead, Inti. Thank you.
Okay. Is that okay, Mr. Annamalai? Can we extend it for some more time?
Time is all yours, ma'am. It's a privilege, ma'am. It's a privilege. Humbled.
இப்ப உங்களை மாதிரி நிறைய பேர் வந்து பப்ளிக் சர்வீஸ்க்கு போகணுங்கிற இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் நிறைய பேருக்கு இருக்கும். ஆனா ஒரு ரிஸ்க் எடுக்கிறதுக்கு ஒரு பயம் இருக்கும் கண்டிப்பா. So pursuing one's passion needs true guts to get out of your comfort zone. But you have done that. But not all can have the space and mental strength with commitments, limiting our decision in terms of family, finance, social, it could be anything. There is a limitation. நமக்கு மனசுல ஆசை இருந்தாலும் வர முடியாத மற்ற சூழ்நிலைகள்லாம் இருக்கும். அப்ப எந்த சமயத்துல அவங்களால டிசைட் பண்றதுக்கான நீங்க ஒரு டிப்ஸ் கொடுக்க முடியும்? ஏன்னா நீங்க பண்ணிருக்கீங்க அத. சோ ஒரு பிரேக் ஈவன் பாயிண்ட் அவங்களுக்கு ஒரு டிப்ஸ் இந்த மாதிரி ஆஸ்பைரிங் டு கெட் இன்டு சோஷியல் சர்வீஸ்.
Right, ma'am. So definitely we can do, ma'am. So maybe I'm not sure I'm the right guy to talk about it, but whatever little change I've taken in my life, with that I'll tell you the background, ma'am. So I always believe the more alignment we have towards the passion we have and the commitment we have from the deep closer to the heart, we find more happiness, ma'am. That is something which I've always found, the alignment. So many of us, the alignment doesn't happen. It just is 90 degree or 180 degree. Or some people, it is almost 360 degree. To do that, I think it's important that we sit down and plan it, ma'am. Plan it. Maybe some of the alumni who's here, the younger alumni wants to jump out and start a company, become an entrepreneur, startup, and do something totally out of the blue. And for them, the only thing I would request or say is, please plan that thing. Plan that thing. The first comes the financial. Definitely, no doubt about that. But I always believe. Finance is all about your comfort zone. If your needs you can control for the next 3-4 years after you take that risk. We cannot afford the same standard of living that we were previously having. That is something which we always have to have in mind. For me, I still remember the 8,000 salary I took at 2007 to 2008. I still remember the initial part of my policing career. I still even now remember now the past 1 year. Bring down the needs a little bit closer for the next 3-4 years, because without doing this, jumping will create a lot of disappointments. The EMIs to be paid, bills to be paid, so it will create a lot of disappointment. So take care of finance first, everything else can follow. The second is, please have a very core team to support and mentor you. So for me, I have a lot of core team, people who kind of really feel for me, mean for me. So those core team, I trust them. I take their advice. So for my, the core team is about 7 to 8 in number, people from Karnataka, people from Tamil Nadu, because many a times we make that emotional decision. So we just jump in because we are blindsided, and I always run it through them. I ask them, should I do it? Should I not do it? And for me, I still remember before quitting, a lot of hard conversations over dinner and lunch, people grilling me, people asking me, is it really I want to do? Is it really I have to do? Is it really closer to my heart? Then they took me through all the failures and what if I fail? What if this doesn't happen? What will happen to my so-called ego and all those stuff? So that hard conversation happened for about 6 months before I quit. So that is the second thing I would say. The third is just jump, because risk is something I would like to say a new perception for risk. So many of you might agree, some might not agree. I remember when I went to Siachen in 2016, the upper Siachen, I saw soldiers at minus 30 degree. A lot of people are there. I found a couple of Kanadiga soldiers because they keep rotating. Siachen is the top area, and the helicopter goes one level down below, and people rotate again to keep going up. The chopper takes them. So when I asked them, because I was part of the All India Police Expedition in that area for some project, I asked a Kanadiga guy, "Anna, risk na yeno? Risk na nakhel khel kurtira?" In Tamil, it is under risk and define. Please define risk for me. He said, "Sir, yen risk? Do you know what risk is? My family is in deep south Mandya, Karnataka. I am like completely up. I haven't seen my wife for about 6 months now. I have a 3-year-old child, and I and Pakistani see eye to eye, because that demilitarized zone, the upper Siachen, it's just about 350 meters. The gap. You could see a Pakistani guy there." Eye to eye. So he might fire a shot up in the air when in a cricket match, when Pakistani guys hit a four, he will just fire a shot just to tell the Indians that a Pakistani is hitting a four. When our Indians take a wicket, our guys will fire one shot. And you never know what will happen the next moment, because it's just a geopolitical shift happening anywhere in the world. The whole edifice will crumble. He said, adu risk na. That is risk for me because I'm not in control of the next moment. But for many of you, when you are planning to kind of switch or look at an alternate career, I don't think you can. You are going to have any of those factors in front of you. Family away from you, you are seeing an enemy eye to eye, and bullet just passing by you, and any geopolitical significance for which you don't have a control will have a control on you. So then my perception about risk changed. As long as we get food, as long as we are happy and comfortable in our means, then what is risk? So my request to all my friends is please redefine risk for you, because each person risk is different. A risk is not same for everybody. You might lose a bit of social prestige. Doesn't matter. When I was at DCP Bangalore, I remember not big guys, small guys. It is not when I'm busy with my office meeting, people used to wait for 30 minutes, 40 minutes. Big guys, people who own companies of 3,000 crore, 5,000 crore. So now I take my car and I go village to village. I meet farmer. I sit in their hut, have their tea, and I convince them, "Anna, nam organization ku vaanga, idha pannalam, idha pannalam, adha pannalam." Though they don't understand anything of what I say, but my passion and my trying, because of that, he joins whatever we are trying to do. So I was willing to forsake that. I said, okay, day one, it's a new degree, new role. I can't bring the old baggage there. So much power. And I had about two personal assistant, two gunmen, two driver, spare car. In Bangalore, always a follow-up party because of a certain threat. Follow-up party, about four people. So always some 10, 20 guys surrounding me. Now new life, I am alone. So this is the computer, I've set it up, I'm here.
So ippo neenga Karur Kalaniki vanda Karnataka Singham.
Ma'am, adala periya varthing ma'am. So very happy in my space, in my village, doing something. So maybe I don't know.
Definitely calls for guts, because neenga vandu you are really flying high. கர்நாடகால வந்து உங்களுக்கு நாங்க ரியல் ஹீரோஸ்க்கு தான் ஃபேன் கிளப்ஸ் பாத்துருக்கோம், பட் ரியல் ஹீரோக்கு ஃபேன் கிளப்ஸ் இப்பதான் நாங்க பாக்குறோம். சோ இந்த அந்த சமயத்துல when you are flying high, you quit and you have come, that's excellent. And now உங்களோட கரண்ட் லைஃப்ல அந்த பெர்ஸ்பெக்டிவ்ல இருந்து see, as patriotism can reduce corruption, tell us how we can encourage strong sense of purpose, integrity and a thirst for nation building in young minds. In other words, I will say, how can we create more anomalies?
Oh, I'm not sure, ma'am, but we can create more unique human beings. We can create more Jayantis and more Febins and more Ratnakumars and more all the 321 alumni here. Own unique human beings, ma'am. So I would say, ma'am, people have to travel more, ma'am. People have to really go deep down and see what is happening in a rural India, in a grassroots India, or if you're in a city, in a slum, in another ashramam, angalam poi paakanum, ma'am. So I always believe people don't have patriotism because they are not exposed. It is not watching a movie once in a while, a Maniratnam Roja or something. When people go around and see, their perspective will change, ma'am. For example, many times when you go to a government hospital, when you see a government nurse in operation, whatever they're doing, your whole perspective about government servant will change, ma'am. Adu policemen night shift pannumbodhu when we see them, very tough, ma'am. Very tough to be a constable, very very tough to be a constable. And enga pasanga pathina varathukku rendu naal our boys will do night rounds, and not only does he do night rounds, next day morning 10 o'clock sharp is back to the station for the day duty. Neraya edathila pathina neraya veetla, for me in Bangalore the rule is I have to do one night round. So every Thursday I am on full city rounds. Maybe people in Bangalore could have seen me if you're awake at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. So, paakumbodhu neraya veetla paathina or flask veli vechirupanga, or flask la vandu coffee or tea avanga gate la vechirupanga. Many places I've seen in Bangalore. I said, why? It is always kept for that night rounds policeman. Night rounds policeman. Always kept. Or a hot water. Vaisana avanga 57 vaisu aalugal la night rounds poitirupanga. So, idhalam paathina somebody has deep down seen what is happening to a police department. Is contributing in their own way by giving a cup of tea. Indha mari neenga patriotism inculcate panna the young boys, young girls, chinna chinna nama students, nama kulandhaiga ella veliya poi neraya vishayangala paaka vekkanum. Nama police station visit, a government school visit, government hospital visit, visit to a farmer, their whole thinking will change. Nama right now
net get inspiration from even common people.
Correct, correct.
Very nice.
So Netflix and Amazon and playing all the video games in the cell phone, I really don't know what are they going to see. Adha pannita podum patriotism vandiruchna neenga sonnad ellame solve aayirum, corruption will go down, you will not get identified by religion, caste. So that is the only solution, ma'am.
So neenga po grassroots level pathi pesitt irundinga. So what is the need of leaders at grassroots level and what is the future of leadership in India?
I am not sure, maybe whether it is the same forum to talk what I am talking now. Neenga pathinga ma'am, India for a long long time, spirituality was always a base for our country. So we used to call as enlightened leadership. Spirituality is not connected to religion, not Hinduism, not Muslim, not Christianity for a long time. So edhukku na spirituality appdi solrana ma'am, and the ul unaradhal appdiengal, spirituality is all about understanding who you are from the inside out, because you have a lot of energy system that is operating in your body. You have your ida and you have your pingala, and there is that 72,000 energy channel inside. So in the present generation pathina idu edhume purinjikama nam outward driven aayittirukkom. So all the leadership right now is outward driven. It's title driven, it's prestige driven, it's designation driven. Adanalada we are seeing CEOs committing blunders. A big bank CEO studied in Harvard committing a financial misappropriation for 2000 crore, going to jail, and with them 6000 people going. Jet Airways collapsing, Kingfisher collapsing, neenga paarenga. So Tamil Nadu always had that spiritual base. Eppume and aanmeegam appdi namakkulla or ul puridhal irundhuchu, because nammudaiya yoga sutra, Patanjali avargal ezhundha yoga sutra 2500 years back was written in Tillai Chidambaram temple by a saint, maybe a jeeva samadhi saint, which talks about the steps you do to achieve it. It talks about 8 steps. 8 step neenga panninga eppadi andha ul puridhal varanum. So anybody who gets that ul puridhal becomes an enlightened leader. I think that is the only way available to our state, ma'am. We have to go deep down inside, control our emotions, control our energy flow, become a absolutely better person, more centered and more oriented and more empathetic. So the pannita podu, ma'am, we get rounded leaders.
self realization,
ma'am. Self realization deep down ulla poganum, ma'am. Adu pogama irukkaradha dhaan prachana, ma'am. That is a big problem. The leadership has to go that way.
So sila per vandu konjam ungaloda rap with Rajinikanth sir pathi therinjikano nariya per aasa padranga, oru few sentences about your rap with him.
My rap with Rajini sir, ma'am, maybe since I am in a public forum, my rap with him is limited to a couple of phone calls, and he has got a new vision, and he wants to do a certain way of politics in our Tamil Nadu. He wants to bring the concept that I am talking, but I'm not sure what does he mean by Anmiga Arasiel. So I think he is meaning the same thing. So idatha avaru panna nenikiraaru, ma'am. So he keeps talking a couple of inputs. I'm not sure, ma'am. So I'm also waiting eagerly like you to see what is he going to bring different to our state.
So we will also wait.
Yes, ma'am. How is he going to take on the mighty Dravidian parties? So I'm waiting, ma'am.
Or a different ala question. See, you've been always bold to embrace change all through your life. If there is one decision you would rethink and would do it differently, what would it be? The cinema la chance kudukuraanga, you can go back,
rewind my life, ma'am. I think I was very very impulsive nu solunga, ma'am. Adavad in initial years of my policing, vegama pannonu nenappa, ma'am. The first 2 years, despite the empathy, despite what I spoke, I always felt I can control things. Cutting things a control panna mudiyum solitte all my decisions used to be. I've put some of my men in the harm's way also, especially this Naxal operation and a lot of things. Maybe neenga Naxal surrender nu sonnadu kuda pathinga, that is something which I rethink. Though I haven't lost any of my boys in Chikmagalur or Udupi when I was part of there, but some of the actions were rash, some of the actions were very driven to bring a change much faster. And the puridhal slower vara, I found each problem has got its own solution at its own time. So on the rethink, ma'am, maybe that the couple of decisions I took with respect to that, I would really go back and do it in a different way. And second, I used to always fight with politicians in the beginning years of my career. Then deep down, when I started seeing them with a different light, for all the ills they have, a system is imperfect, society is not very mature, adukapram pathina nariya politician I started becoming friends to them. So and the part of immaturity I would like to go back, ma'am. Otherwise I'm happy with whatever decisions I've taken, ma'am.
Okay, that's nice. So there's one question. What are the opportunities for women in government administration jobs once she has crossed the age for writing the exams, but with good skill sets and strong inspiration with age above 40? Ungaloda seniors tend varu questions idu.
You should straight away aim to be an advisor to the ministers and the prime ministers and the chief minister, because India is becoming very technocratic now, ma'am, whether you like it or not. And நீங்க கரெக்ட்டா உள்ள இருந்து பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா for the specific question the answer is the government is doing lot of lateral recruitment. Last 2 years ஆ பாத்தீங்கன்னா இந்த மோடி கவர்மெண்ட் வந்து lateral recruitment பண்றாங்க. You get to join IAS but in a different way. This is important for many of our alumni who have crossed 40 now. In 2019 the first time when it opened they recruited 10 people. நீங்க நோட்டிபிகேஷன் பாத்திருப்பீங்க DOPT government of India, it said you should cross 40 years of age, you should have achieved some sort of distinction in your professional life, please apply. So ungalku 5 years government of india la vela seyaradhukku avakasam kudupanga. You can be a joint secretary and above government of india. Ipo irukra joint secretary aviation financial services ellarume pathinga na inda lateral idhula vandavanga. So I think 2 women have come and 8 male have gone there. So this is one thing people should consider. It is still available, still open for 2020 2021. Now this batch they're doing it differently. Not only have they opened at 40, they're opening at the director level also. Or IAS ulla pona onne neenga 5 varshathula director aayiruvinga adhiley open panni indha varsham 30 seat open pannitaanga. So people should use this lateral entry option to get into government of india for a 5 year break. Neenga 5 year private sector la break eduthittu come to government, work for 5 years and go back. And many a times I see in meetings, even now when I have the privilege of advising some political guys, some administrators, avanga room ellam pombodu na paapa ma'am, very young girls they sit there, very young boys they sit there. Okay, appa neengala yaar enna na advise pandren avangalukku, policy advisor, social media advisor, indha mari the politicians are the chief ministers and the prime ministers. They are very happy to listen to people who have a certain expertise. The expertise can be in governance, it can be in social media management, it can be in personality management. So that is one space that is open, man. You can really influence government's thinking. So adu rendu neenga correct plan panni correctly, if you can do a public policy course, maybe after 40 you go to John F. Kennedy School of Governance or Fletcher School of Diplomacy, India la vandu Delhi la Ashoka University, if you do a public policy course, you come back, there are a lot of opportunities open for you in government. Lot of opportunities. You need not be a civil servant, you can do 10 times more than a civil servant by being at the background. So ellam neenga explore pannalam, ma'am. This India is very different. 10 years back it was not there. My only request is, I think many women specifically, because the country needs more empathetic leaders, the country needs more women who can really understand, because women really understand different perceptions very fast than male. This is my personal experience also. So nariya varanum, ma'am. So it's a great question, ma'am. So there are a lot of opportunities for them.
Okay. So this is again from mainly our seniors. Please share your views and suggestions on how technology can be leveraged to detect and prevent crimes more effectively and efficiently.
Sir, neenga oru Bangalore city police mari pathinga appadina, now we are very very advanced. Tech advances is like fabulous. We are deep learning, machine learning, artificial intelligence, mood analysis, ellame pandrom sir. Every single thing we do, big data, everything we do. And now all those gives us a lot of insightful information, like we are in a position to predict where the next crime will happen. So Bangalore city ella pathinga na chain snatching is very common. Inga yara chirkingla nu therla Chennai la kuda big city, the big menace is chain snatching. Pengal nadandu walking povanga chain a padakku eduthu poiruvanga. So now Bangalore, I think we are able to predict with close to 50% accuracy where are the next possible chain snatching spots. So avanga patrol vehicles move pandreenga. Now we are also able to predict the house burglary enga nadakkum based on the pattern of movement. IT ஆளுங்க எங்க வசிக்கிறாங்க, எப்ப வீட்டுக்கு போவாங்க, லாங் ஹாலிடேஸ் எப்ப இருக்கு. சோ அதனால டெக்னாலஜி வந்து இட் இஸ் பிளேயிங் எ மேஜர் மேஜர் ரோல். அகைன் நீங்க கேட்டீங்கன்னா பீப்பிள் லைக் யூ ஆர் த பீப்பிள் டூ இட், நன் ஆஃப் த போலீஸ் கைஸ் டூ இட், இட்ஸ் ஆல் அவுட் சோர்ஸ்ட். அண்ட் அகைன் 81 பேட்ச் பிஎஃப்ஜி அலுமினி இஸ் த கை ஹூ ரன்ஸ் ஆர் பெங்களூர் டேட்டா ஆபரேஷன் சென்டர். சோ ஹி ஒர்க்ஸ் ஃபார் அ கம்பெனி இன் பெங்களூர், சோ ஹி இஸ் ஆர் அலுமினி ஹூ ரன்ஸ் ஆர் கண்ட்ரோல் சென்டர் ஹூ ரன்ஸ் ஆல் ஆர் ஹொய்சலாஸ். பெங்களூர் ஹஸ் காட் அபவுட் 2500 பிங்க் வெஹிக்கிள்ஸ் விச் கோஸ் எனிவேர் டு வென் பீப்பிள் கீப் அ கால் give a call. So all nariya pannalanga, technology is a great level. I am happy that Chennai, Bangalore and big cities have adapted to it, ma'am.
Okay. Nice. And on the speech la neenga vandu nammaloada developmental, no, western model of development pathi sonninga. I also feel that we are blindly following the Western model of development, which is wreaking havoc in our environment. This is especially tragic since Indian knowledge systems stress the importance of sustainability, of living in harmony with nature, respecting life. In fact, it's coincidence that we are now in the Adi Masam, where our festival seasons begin, and we start with living in harmony with nature. First, we will start our festivals only with praying to nature. We do our puja to river goddess. So how can we move to a more thoughtful indigenous model for life and development?
Ma'am, I think it's a great question, but if you don't mind a small deviation, I'll again get back, ma'am. So just a small deviation. Poll of Tamil Nadu pathinga the last ஒரு வாரம் வந்து அந்த கந்தசஷ்டி கவசம் ஐ எம் ஜஸ்ட் லிங்கிங் திஸ் டு யுவர் க்வெஸ்சன் யூ ஆஸ்க் கந்தசஷ்டி கவசத்தை இன்சல்ட் பண்ணிட்டாங்கன்னு பொலிட்டிக்கலி பீப்புள் ஆர் டாக்கிங் நவ வென் வி லுக் டீப் டவுன் இன்டு அவர் கல்ச்சர் இப்போ கந்தசஷ்டி கவசத்தை ஒரு உதாரணமாக எடுத்துக்கிட்டிங்க அப்படின்னா ஸோ ரிட்டன் பை தேவராயர் அபவுட் 200 இயர்ஸ் பேக் அவர் எழுதின ஒரு பாடல் அதை நீங்கள் கரெக்டாக அந்த காலத்து தமிழ் 200 இயர்ஸ் பேக்குக்கு தமிழுக்கு நீங்கள் லிங்க் பண்ணி நிறையா டிரான்ஸ்லேஷன் இன்டர்நெட்ல இருக்கு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இட் டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் தி 7 லேயர்ஸ் ஆஃப் எனர்ஜி சிஸ்டம்ஸ் அரவுண்ட் யூ இட் டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் controlling your inside energy, it talks about channelizing that energy to prevent any sort of disease. இதெல்லாம் உள்ள தான் மேம் இருக்கிறது. But this will happen only when we are very close to nature. Because being close to nature is the very natural way of living. Remaining எல்லாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா artificial way of living ஆயிருக்கு. But natural way of livingல இருக்கும்போது என்ன ஆகுனா மேம் you focus more on yourself, more on your energy system. There is an interplay with everything that is around you. அதை தாண்டி இப்போ நம்ம வெளியே வந்தாச்சு. Where there are a lot of things that control me outside. Cell phones and technology and all those stuff. So that is why probably this generation is the most disappointed generation. Despite achieving everything, they're very disappointed. They're not very happy, not very contented, very jumpy. Nariya cancer patients, a lot of lifestyle diseases. Nariya irukuma. So idu maaranum appdin pathina, we have to first understand that science might not give answers to everything. Possibly in some spaces, science might be at least 200 years behind us, some places. That is what the great scriptures say. I'm not talking of a religious scripture, but scientific scriptures written long time back. Thirumbadala kondu varana ma'am, the way we eat, the way we live. Oru kaalathula Tamil and eppadi vaazhndha ma'am, ungalaoda unava neengale urpatti pananum appdin oru kaalagattathil irundhuchu. Adhaavadhu oru unava naachi neenga eduthu neenga adha senju saapannum appdi. It could be a small cucumber, it could be a small thing that is grown in your thing. You eat it so that you connect with nature. இப்ப பாத்தீங்கன்னா எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் க்ரோன் வாட் 200 கிலோமீட்டர்ஸ் அவே 500 கிலோமீட்டர்ஸ் அவே மெனி திங்ஸ் வி இம்போர்ட் அண்ட் ஈட் ஸோ எல்லாமே மாறிடுச்சு மேம் எவ்ரி திங் அண்ட் வே வி லிவ் அண்ட் வே வி யூஸ் டெக்னாலஜி எவ்ரி திங் ஹஸ் சேஞ்ச்ட் அண்ட் வி டோன்ட் லிவ் வித் அவர் பேரண்ட்ஸ் எனி மோர் கிராண்ட் பேரண்ட்ஸ் எனி மோர் இதெல்லாம் உட்காந்து யோசிக்கணும் மேம் பிகாஸ் நார்மலி வென் வி கோ இன் அ ஸ்பீடிங் ட்ரெயின் எவ்ரி திங் வில் அப்பியர் வெரி பிளர்டி டு அஸ் சேம் திங் இஸ் ஹேப்பனிங் வித் அவர் லைஃப் யூ ஆர் ஆன் அ வெரி ஸ்பீடிங் ட்ரெயின் அண்ட் எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் பிளர்ட் டு அஸ் ஐ ஹோப் அண்ட் ப்ரே பீப்பிள் டேக் அ மொமெண்ட் டு சிட் பேக் ரீகனெக்ட் And Thirling, ma'am, how many of you had the opportunity for News 18 Tamil? For the first 21 days of lockdown, I wrote 21 articles, ma'am, 21 series of articles. All series of articles was exactly this. Every single day, we took one. We wrote about that. One day on me, one day about food, one day about our old life, all those stuff, ma'am. So, nariya adha pesi irukum, ma'am. Maybe I'll share the link. So, I had the opportunity to write, ma'am. So, neenga ketta arumiyana kelvi, ma'am. But only an individual person can be a change agent. They have to really rethink their lives.
That's nice. So as John F. Kennedy famously urged, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. So
definitely
namma enna pannanum da first paakanum. That's nice. Fabin, how many more minutes we have? How many questions can we have? Because we have many questions.
Yeah, we can go on maybe another one question. By 8, we'll try to close.
Okay.
Is it okay, Mr. Annamalai?
Absolutely fine, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay. So, Mr. Annamalai, could you please share one situation when you realized, in spite of testing time, staying true to yourself gave deeper meaning to life?
Ma'am, please repeat the question, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am.
Could you please share one situation when you realized the self-realization, Pathi Pesnolia, in spite of testing time, staying true to yourself gave deeper meaning to life.
Okay. Many times. So what happened is, as a cop, I don't know, maybe the insiders will say, I always put a lot of premium and effort on protecting my men. Police level is very important, man. A lot of people are under you, sub-inspector, inspector and all ranks. There is a lot of political pressure. So for me, the first thing I always do is I insulate them. Any problem I take, there'll be a lot of pressure on me to transfer them. There are instances where I got transferred. I was posted to a district for only one day as SP. But every single time it is because I was protecting somebody. I was not allowing somebody to touch boys under me. I always used to take a lot of pride and a lot of happiness doing that, man. So that I was always clear, always, always clear, because my job as a leader is to protect my men so that he is absolutely comfortable to be fearless to take those action. But for which I suffered professionally. A couple of times I suffered professionally and a medal that was due was not given, but doesn't matter. In the long run, it doesn't matter. It's all small things here and there. But right now, when I see them growing up, when I see all my boys with superb confidence doing great in the field, I feel happy and proud, ma'am. So that is one moment, ma'am. It's a personal loss to me, but I'm not saying again that is a loss, but very, very pride moment for me. Never sacrifice that stand anytime, ma'am.
Very good, very good. There's one question relating to, again, the politics. When even sports persons are trained and selected to represent at district, state and national levels, why is that there is no training and selection process for a politician? I think he means for contesting itself. Is an entire country cheaper than sports?
Oh, this question requires at least 4 minutes, ma'am. Maybe 7:55 now, 5 minutes I'll take and finish it off, ma'am. Thank you. Now, this is a question always people ask, ma'am, in colleges, wherever I have the opportunity to speak. They say, politician got a degree, we know, politician got training, we know, how can they contest the election? I go back to the era of Kamarajar, ma'am. If you happen to read his life story, read his book, and this guy never went to a school, even when rains came. This guy never got trained anywhere. A proper son of soil, climbed all the way up. I'm going to say one instant, not about Kamarajar, but about three people. Kamarajar's cabinet itself, the answer panna ve namak therinjirum, ma'am, where are we going wrong? So Kamarajar had three legendary people in his cabinet. So 1954, when Rajaji resigned, Kamarajar took over as a CM. So Kamarajar had Kamarajar, he had Kakkan, he had Jeeva. Three stalwarts. All three you put in a justice scale, all three will be equal. Not even one fellow will go up, one fellow will come down. அப்போ வந்து பாத்தீங்கன்னா ஒரு ஒரு நாள் வந்து காமராஜர் கோஸ் டு ஜீவாஸ் பிளேஸ். ஜீவா வாஸ் ஆர் மினிஸ்டர் தென். வென் ஹி கோஸ் டு ஜீவாஸ் பிளேஸ், ஹி ஃபவுண்ட் ஜீவா இஸ் நாட் கமிங் அவுட். காமராஜர் சொல்றார், நான் வந்துட்டேன் பா, ஜீவாவை கூப்பிடும், பிகாஸ் காமராஜர் ஹஸ் டு பிக் ஹிம் இன் ஹிஸ் கார் அண்ட் கோ டு அஃபீஷியல் ஃபங்க்ஷன். கதவை தட்டுறாங்க, ஜீவா வரல. ஸோ காமராஜர் சென்ட் சம்படி போய் பாருங்க ஏன் ஜீவா வரலன்னு. உள்ள போய் பாத்தீங்கன்னா ஜீவா வந்து, ஜீவா ஹேட் ஒன்லி டூ தோத்தி, ரெண்டே ரெண்டு வேட்டி தான் அவருக்கு இருந்துச்சு மேம். ஒரு வேட்டி கட்டிட்டாரு, ஒரு வேட்டியை புளிஞ்சு போட்டார், அது வெயில காஞ்சிட்டு இருந்துச்சு. ஸோ ஹி ஹஸ் டு வியர் தட் வேட்டி, தட் தோத்தி அண்ட் ஜாயின் காமராஜர் ஃபார் அ ஃபங்க்ஷன். இவங்க எல்லாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா எவ்ரிபடி கேம் ஃப்ரம் கிராஸ் ரூட்ஸ். தே டிட் நாட் வாண்ட் எனி ட்ரைனிங் ஆர் எனி டிகிரி எவ்ரி திங். த லைஃப் இட் செல்ஃப் தாட் தம் எவ்ரி திங். தட் இஸ் வை காமராஜர் ஈவன் நவ் நோபடி குட் பீட் த கெனால்ஸ் தட் இ பில்ட், த டேம்ஸ் தட் இ பில்ட், த ஸ்கூல்ஸ் தட் இ பில்ட். ஈவன் நவ் டிஸ்பைட் த சோ மெனி டெக்னாலஜிஸ் வி ஹேவ் மேம், அவர் பீரியட்ல கட்டின இதை இன்னும் யாருமே தொடக்கூடல. நாட் ஈவன் பீப்புள் ஹவ் ரீச்ட் 50% ஆஃப் காமராஜர். ஸோ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கிளாஸ் தே ஆர். பட் ரைட் நோ பொலிட்டிக்கல் ஆஸ்பிரேஷன் இருக்கிற பசங்க என்ன பண்றாங்க மேம், த நியூ பீப்புள் தி ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் அவே ஜம்ப், தோ தே ஹவ் குட் இன்டென்ஷன், ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் அவே ஜம்ப் இன் டு பாலிடிக்ஸ். இட் டசன்ட் கட் மச் ஐஸ் மேம், பிகாஸ் இந்தியன் எலெக்ஷன் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங் இஸ் மோர் அபவுட் ஐடென்டிட்டி, வி ஹவ் டு கெட் ஐடென்டிஃபை. த செகண்ட் திங் இஸ் அபவுட் ஃபெமிலியாரிட்டி. The third thing is more about connectivity. Are they really connected to us? Now, ungalukku edhaachum pannirukkana, phone panni pesirukkana. The existing political guys have already done it so much, many times. So new guy paathina, the grassroots approach ellama direct ah kudikiraanga man. That is a big problem. So irukkira politician kuda paathina, yen namak veriya bad ah theriyraanga appadina, I would blame 50% of the system. A book varapodum ma'am, Bloomsbury, I have just written a book for them. It will get published in the month of August. There is one chapter exclusively on the Indian politician. ஏன் அப்படி இருக்காங்க, எப்படி மாற்ற முடியும்னு சொல்லிட்டு மேம். அதில் ஒன் திங் ஐ மென்ஷன், தெர் இஸ் பீப்புள் ஹவ் பிகம் பேட் ஓவர் அ பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் டைம் பிகாஸ் த சிஸ்டம் இஸ் கரப்ட், சிஸ்டம் இஸ் ஸோ பேட் அண்ட் த பீப்புள் ஆல்சோ டோன்ட் புட் எம்ஃபசிஸ் ஆன் தெம். எ பேட் கை இஃப் இஸ் பேட், பீப்புள் ஷுட் எலெக்ட் ஹிம் அவுட். பட் அன்ஃபார்ச்சுனேட் இந்தியன் டெமோக்ரஸியில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா பேட் கை கெட்ஸ் ரீஎலெக்டட் பிகாஸ் இந்த நான் சொன்ன மூணு விஷயத்தை அவன் யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கிறான். ஹி யூசஸ் த கனெக்டிவிட்டி, ஹி யூசஸ் த ஃபெமிலியாரிட்டி, இது ரெண்டு யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கிறான். ஃபார் அ நியூ கை என்ட்ரிங் வித்வுட் அ கிராஸ் ரூட்ஸ் அப்ரோச் ஸ்டஃப், மக்கள் உங்களை பார்க்கல, வி நெவர் ஸ்வெட்டட் இன் த சன், வி நெவர் சேஞ்ச் த காமன் மேன்ஸ் லைஃப், இது மாறணும் மேம். ஸோ வென் வி டூ இட் மேபி தட் இஸ் அ ட்ரைனிங் வி ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங். அ நியூ கை ஹேஸ் டு கோ த்ரூ த ட்ரைனிங். ஸோ காமராஜர் காட் ட்ரெயின்டு பை இஸ் மதர், ட்ரெயின் ஃபார் அபவுட் 20 years, 25 years. Same thing if you apply to Anna. Anna born in Kanchipuram. Brought up by a foster mother. Anna kuda pathingana tattu thai dhaan valathaanga. Though he had a mother, but innorthungalukku kolandhaiyil Anna thookit poitaanga. So they grew up Anna in a certain way. So Anna is Anna. 1967 to 69, Tamil Nadu CM. But fantastic, fantastic man. Fantastic he has done. He redeemed Tamil Nadu. He brought a lot of systems in place. அதுக்குத்தான் தமிழ்நாடு இஸ் வெரி லக்கி மேம். வேற ஸ்டேட்ல நீங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா யூ கேன் நேம் ஒன் லீடர் ஆர் டூ லீடர், பட் தமிழ்நாடு ஹேட் அ ஃபேபுலஸ் லீடர்ஸ். த ஹோல் ப்ராப்ளம் இஸ் இன் த லாஸ்ட் 10 இயர்ஸ் பிகாஸ் இவங்களுக்கு அதே ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டியில் அவர் குரூம் ஆகி வரல மேம். தே நெவர் கேம் பேக் த ஹம்பிள் வே. ஸோ ரைட் நவ் இட்ஸ் மணி. ஐ எம் அ ரியல் எஸ்டேட் காய், ஐ கேன் ஸ்பெண்ட் 2000 ஃபார் எவ்ரி ஓட், ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் அவே ஐ கெட் அ டிக்கெட், ஐ கம் இன். திஸ் அ ப்ராப்ளம். ஐ எம் அ மூவி ஸ்டார், ஐ ஹவ் லாட் ஆஃப் ஃபேன்ஸ், ஐ கன்வெர்ட் தம் இன் டு பொலிட்டிக்கல் ஆக்டர்ஸ், ஐ கம் இன் சைட், இட்ஸ் அ ப்ராப்ளம். ஸோ இது தமிழ்நாட்டில் அன்ஃபார்ச்சுனேட்லி இது லாஸ்ட் 20 இயர்ஸ் உள்ள வந்துருச்சு மேம். ஐடியாலஜி ஹஸ் டேக்கன் அ பேக் சீட் அண்ட் அ கிராஸ் ரூட்ஸ் கனெக்ட் ஹஸ் டேக்கன் அர்லஸ் சார் ஹஸ் மென்ஷன் லாஸ்ட் 30 இயர்ஸ். ஆக்சுவலி ஐ அக்ரி வித் யூ சார், இது மாறணும் மேம். த ட்ரைனிங் இஸ் நாட் ஹேப்பனிங். தட் இஸ் வை வி ஆர் சீயிங் வெரி பேட் பொலிட்டிக்கல் ஆக்டர்ஸ் ஹூ ஆர் இன் ஆர் தியேட்டர் நவ். ஐ எம் நாட் ஷுர் மேம் வெதர் ஐ ஆன்சர்ட் யுவர் க்வெஸ்சன், பட் திஸ் இஸ் வாட் மை இம்ப்ரெஷன் மேம்.
ஓகே. So now we have come to the grand finale question. Many of our alumni members are not only residing in Tamil Nadu, in India and abroad, the NRIs even want to know, in what way can alumni help in your mission?
I think in many ways you should help, sir. I think people who are above 45, 50, who are really contented with life, there is a huge political opportunity that is available for you. You need not contest elections, 100% no. But you can really shape up a lot of political guys. All you have to do is connect, ma'am. You have to connect. I still remember in 2010 in IIM Lucknow, I sent an email to Banduti Ramachandran, who was a presidium chairman of DMDK. Just a small email. I said, I am so-and-so. I would like to work for you. Can I come? He said, yes. So, and the initiative நாம நிறைய பேர் எடுக்கிறது இல்லைங்க. So, you should come back to our state, maybe by emails, maybe by video. Now, technology is a great leveler now. Start grooming the current generation of politics. நீங்க ஒரு இமெயில் போட்டீங்கன்னா 100% they respond to you. You take my word, sir. அது மாதிரி ஒன்று பண்ணலாம். இப்போ எங்க மிஷனுக்கு டைரக்டா நீங்க கான்ட்ரிபியூட் பண்ணணும்னு நினைச்சிங்க அப்படின்னா, மேபி த வி த லீடர்ஸ் தி ஃபார்மிங் ப்ராஜெக்ட் அண்ட் த ஸ்கில்லிங் ப்ராஜெக்ட், வி ஹாவ் அ ப்ராஜெக்ட் கால் ப்ராஜெக்ட் சன்ரைஸ் அலாங் வித் 247.ai. இட்ஸ் அ பிக் ப்ராஜெக்ட் வி ரன். ஸோ நீங்கள் மென்டார்ஸாக வரலாம் சார், அட்வைசர்ஸாக வரலாம், எங்களை மென்டார் பண்ணலாம். ஸோ நீங்கள் ஹெல்ப் பண்ணலாம் எங்களுக்கு. ஸோ அதனால் நீங்கள் லார்ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்பேஸில் பார்க்கலாம் சார். ஒன், யூ கேன் ஹெல்ப் அஸ் அண்ட் செகண்ட் யூ கேன் ஹெல்ப் ஆர் ஸ்டேட் ஆல்சோ. பட் ஐ வுட் அட்வைஸ் யூ டு க்ரூம் தி கரண்ட் பொலிட்டிக்கல் செட்டப். கொஞ்சம் க்ரூம் பண்ணுங்கள், லெட் தம் ஸ்டார்ட் திங்கிங் ரைட், ட்ரெயின் தோஸ் கேடர்ஸ். அவங்க கேடரை ட்ரெயின் பண்ணுறது பெரிய ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி. இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஃப்ரீ, யூ டெல் Mr. Kamalhasan or Mr. Tamilna or Mr. Rajini or Mr. Seeman or Mr. Stalin, whoever it is, Mr. Edappadi, just connect with them, tell them that you are willing to train their cadres for free on people management, personality development. Kandipa utkuvaanga. Neenga romba bayapadadhinga, ayyo nama veli irukom, nammala ulla poga mudiyadhunu. It is always the outsiders who make the difference. Always. Always the outsiders. Adhanal neenga, you all have to do is an email or a Twitter connect. So adha pannunga. நம்ம ஸ்டேட்டை கொஞ்சம் பொலிட்டிக்கல் டைரக்ஷனை சேஞ்ச் பண்ணி விடுங்க. சோஷியல் ஆர்கனைசேஷன் எங்களே மாதிரி நிறைய பேர் இருக்காங்க. ஸோ மேபி சம் ஆர் ரன் பை அலுமினி, சம் ஆர் நாட். ப்ளீஸ் மென்டர் அஸ், ப்ளீஸ் கிவ் யுவர் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் டு அஸ். வி வுட் லைக் டு ரியலி நோ யுவர் பாத் அண்ட் யுவர் ஜேர்னி அண்ட் டேக் இட் டு ஆர் வாலண்டியர்ஸ் அண்ட் க்ரூம் தெம் த பெட்டர் வே. மேம், தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் ஆஸ்கிங் திஸ் க்வெஸ்டன் மேம். இஃப் எனி ஆஃப் யூ ஆர் வில்லிங் டு ஹெல்ப் அஸ், இட் வில் பி அ கிரேட் பிரிவிலேஜ் அண்ட் ஹானர் ஃபார் ஆல் ஆஃப் அஸ். தேங்க்யூ ஸோ மச் மேம்.
தேங்க்யூ அண்ணாமலை. மாற்றம் ஒன்றே மாறாதது. ஒரு மிகச்சிறந்த மாற்றத்தை உருவாக்க, அந்த மாற்றத்தை உருவாக்குவதற்கான ஒரு மாற்றுப்பாதையை தனக்கென தேர்ந்தெடுத்து அந்த பாதையில் பல மாற்றங்களை உருவாக்கி கொண்டிருக்கும் நமது அண்ணாமலை அவர்களுக்கு உங்கள் அனைவர் சார்பாகவும் நல்வாழ்த்துக்களை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். அண்ட் தேங்க்யூ சோ மச் மிஸ்டர் அண்ணாமலை. தேங்க்யூ சோ மச். ஓவர் டு ஃபெவன்.
Thank you, ma'am. Big shout out to all the organizers, ma'am. I'll be failing in my duty if I don't thank you. It is one of the best webinar I have attended. Very professional, very thorough, right down to the mic check, right down to everything. So fantastic, ma'am. Thank you so much. So it's a honor and privilege, ma'am. Ramban Andring, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Annamalai, once again, for your candid and transparent take on all the topics. And we wish you all the very best for all your endeavors. And we hope to keep in touch with you.
Anytime, ma'am. Anytime. Thank you.
Thanks, Jayanti, for maneuvering the session and giving us all a wonderful experience. I once again thank the team that worked behind this webinar. Lakshmi, Karthi, Venkat, our EC numbers, Ravi, Anant, and Vadivel, along with me, Jayanti, and Ratna, Prabram sir, and all the EC members who have supported. And I thank all the participants today. We have extended the session. You have all been very patient, and also for the questions that you have asked, which made the session more, very interesting. And I'm seeing the chats, so much of feedback, so much of positive thoughts for you, Mr. Annamalai. So I'm sure you also have seen it. I have a request to all the participants, please fill in the feedback form. I have posted it a few times in the chat and will also be sending you mails. Please fill the feedback form, which will take you only a few seconds, so we can further enhance our alumni interaction experience. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Good night.